What's up, everyone? My name is Where I Don't Care My Name Is, and here we go with my review for the final episode of Season 2 of The Mandalorian, The Rescue. That's right, we're finally here. This is the season finale. I'm very sad. I've been very much enjoying this season. But, of course, all good things have to come to an end. This is not a long season, just like the last one. So I'm very much looking forward to discussing with you guys everything that happened here and what we can expect for the next season. But for right now, let's go over the episode. And of course, there's going to be some spoilers here. You've been warned. It's in the title of the video. So I don't know why you click on and then get mad at that I spoiled everything. So the episode opens up with Mando's team capturing Dr. Perishing, the scientist from the first two episodes of The Mandalorian of Season 1, who we later find out is a clone engineer. So, okay, and that gives us a bit of a hint of why the child was needed. They needed his blood for something, and, you know, that can't be good. Mando and Boba head to find Bo-Katan and her group to gain their help to free Grogu. Bo agrees, but only after a rough tension between her and Boba Fett, and they form a plan to get to the ship to get to Grogu, while the others go after Moff Gideon. Now, Bo makes it clear that she wants Moff Gideon on her own. But Mando agrees, decides he just wants the child, so they go and infiltrate the ship. Now, Bo's group takes out the stormtroopers and even get to the bridge while Mando goes after Grogu. He manages to stop the Stark troopers from getting out of their facility after they've been, out of their room after they've been activated. However, one Dark Trooper managed to get through the door before Mando closes it, and Mando gets his ass kicked. I mean, he tries everything. He tries shooting the Dark Trooper. He tries using every single one of his weapons. They don't work until finally he uses the Baskar's spear, and that finally puts it down, and he sends the rest of the Dark Troopers out into space. Mando manages to find Grogu, but is confronted by Moff Gideon, who is holding the child hostage. Moth offers a child to Mando, but in exchange he must leave, and he already has what he needs. He already has his blood, he already studied it, so he can go. But the trap, Gideon tries to kill Mando. The two of them have a big fight, with the Darksaber being used by Gideon while Mando uses the Baskar spear, but Mando manages to defeat him and ends up bringing him to Bo-Katan. However, she's angry that Moth was defeated by Mando, because the way for her to regain the Darksaber is she must defeat the owner of it in combat. Because Mando defeated Gideon, he is the owner of the Darksaber now. Things get even worse when the Dark Troopers that Mando threw into space, they come back. It turns out Mando forgot their droids, they're not people, so doesn't go according to plan when he sends them to space. So they come back, and the group are about to fight them until an X-Wing arrives and the Dark Troopers are confronted by a Jedi, but not just any Jedi. Luke freaking Skywalker. Oh my god. Okay, I saw somebody posted it's gonna be Luke. I didn't think that was gonna be him. I actually thought it was gonna be someone else, but nope, it was Luke. A CGI young version of him, but still. Luke freaking Skywalker shows up. He takes out the Dark Trooper so freaking easily. He then meets with Mando, and Mando knows it's time for him and Grogu to depart. So he says goodbye to Grogu, removes his helmet. It is such a touching but great moment. And the two part ways, and that's how the episode ends. Or is it? Nope, it's not over yet. Turns out there's a post-credit scene where on Tatooine, in Jabba's old palace, it's been taken over by someone else. I'm not going to bother learning the name, because that person ends up being killed by Boba Fett, who returns to planet Tatooine with Fennec Shand. They kill the leader, and Boba takes the throne, and now he is ruler of, I guess, the Hutt Empire. I don't know. All I know is it was an awesome shot. And the episode ends with a title, The Book of Boba Fett, coming December 2021. So I guess The Mandalorian is going to continue, but it's going to focus on Boba Fett. Hopefully so, and I'm looking forward to that. But yep, that's pretty much how the episode ends. Okay, so It was fun to see Bo-Katan and her group return, although we only saw Sasha in this. We didn't get any airtime with Simon, who I don't think was even in the episode at all. It was also interesting to see Bo and Boba Fett knowing, you know, the heat exchange between the two. Bo knowing that he's not Mandalorian, he's a clone. And it gets to the point where Boba and Sasha get into a fight and she hits a tornado DDT on Boba Fett. That was awesome. It was also great to see Moth Gideon back and just him confronting Mando and just him mocking Bo because she knows she can't get the Darksaber unless she beats Mando in a fight, and he starts, you know, having a great time with it, even though, yeah, he lost this fight, but he seemed to have a lot of fun just mocking them. Also, love this, like, the finale there where we see, you know, Mando and Grogu just parting ways. Oh my god, it's so sad. I really liked how this episode went, you know, except for the part that, you know, since Grogu went with Luke, that means, oh boy, that's not gonna end well for him if he ends up being killed by Kylo Ren. But anyways, the special effects for the episode were not bad. I did like the fight scenes here, both showing how dangerous the Dark Troopers are, you know, how they, Mando tries everything, he can't destroy it until he finally was able to kill it with the Baskar spear, but that was just one Dark Trooper. I don't think he would have been able to take on every one of them on his own. And it was also fun to see Mando against Moth Gideon. It was a lot. That was a pretty cool fight there. It wasn't long, but it was still not bad. Although I wasn't expecting a big fight finale like what we got from season one, but it was still not bad. But seeing Luke appear and just destroy the Dark Troopers with ease, like the last one he destroyed with the Force, he started crushing the freaking thing with his bare hand. I'm like, whoa, man, Luke has gone freaking strong. But yeah, this was not a bad episode. I really like how this looked, from the plot of the finale to the characters, seeing them all come together, and then seeing the fight scenes and seeing the Dark Troopers. It was awesome. I kind of wish we got a little bit more fights with the Dark Troopers, but still, it was not bad. Love the episode, and very happy how well this went. So, a good finale, a very sad finale, but a good finale. So, that's pretty much it, guys. If you have a different opinion about this episode, leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. Hit the subscribe button, check out my Facebook page, check out my Twitter page, check out my Instagram, and also check out T3 Media's channel, subscribe to their channel, keep up to date with their videos. And I'll see you next time to give you more love and more entertainment. Until then, take care, be safe, love y'all, and goodbye.